you play with your friends?
Guido, we're back. Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to another episode of the one and only world famous Stranglemania.
That's right, folks, Stranglemania 2.
I'm your host, Diamond Donovan Douglas, better known as 3D, baby.
And I'm Handsome Harley Guastella, but to my friends, including you, 3D,
thank you.
You can call me Guido.
As you can see, we're coming live and direct from the world-famous Chlamydia Stadium here in Osaka, Japan, and we'll be bringing you the return of many great legends, as well as many newcomers, all doing battle in the square circle of exploding nipples. Now, Guido, tell us who we're starting with and what we can see first here on Stranglemania 2.
Well, you might not believe your ears, 3D, when I say this, but it's true. He will be strapping the tights back on and jumping back in the barbed wire. None other than
Lama Nama Numi, ladies and gentlemen. He will be taking on newcomer Hollywood Chuck Hogan in an exploding ladder barbed wire death match.
That's right, and that's not all, folks. Also, we got another newcomer coming to Stranglemania. He's been feared on the streets for years around here.
You can't be talking about Armageddon, are you?
That's right, asshole Andy Armageddon.
Asshole Andy Armageddon, you'll see him finally. It's only been speculative rumors, but now you'll see him live and direct live. Asshole Army Andy Geddon will be taking on none other than Sweet Baby Bitch.
That's right, Sweet Baby Bitch going up against Awesome Andy Anderson, and that's going to be in barbed wire, fire. Not only that, but they get a ninja weapon of their choice, 3D.
That's right. Also, first time ever seen anywhere in the world that we live in today, you will see two chicks doing battle, toe-to-toe, head-to-head, nipple-to-nipple. And I'm talking about Armageddon's younger sister, Sweaty Nedden Armageddon. And she will be taking on, in a barbed wire death match, Sweet Bitch Ass.
That's right. Fierce competition like none other seen
Sweet
before.
Sweet Sugar Ass will be taking on Sweaty Nedden Armageddon.
Sweet Sugar Ass. And like I was saying, competition like you've never seen before between two chicks.
That's right. Only on Stranglemania 2. Now, let's talk about what we'll be viewing in just a little bit here and there. In between matches, you'll see some classic footage from 1917 from the Duck Dome in Georgia, Louisiana.
That's right. Vintage footage. Vintage footage. You hear these people mention on all your local news broadcasts if you're an old man like myself.
Some of you old-timers might remember these names. The Fortified Hooligan will be taking on the Masked Cabana in a rare Matt Classic. We'll be showing you footage of that. Let's talk about our main event.
The main event?
The main event.
Okay, let's talk about it then. The return of none other than Drunk Terry Funk.
114 years old, Drunk Terry Funk still not finished wrestling. He will be taking on the dangerous one, Asshole Andy Armageddon, in an exploding ring, tangling turnbuckle, barbed wire.
One second, if I could. I couldn't notice this gentleman walking around behind us.
Ladies and gentlemen, I forgot to mention, Guido in 3D will also be joined by the most controversial man in professional wrestling today. Introduce yourself.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Luscious Johnny Stark.
He will be offering his input on some of these razor blade death matches. Johnny, give us your predictions on the outcome. Did you also know that the Mushroom Boys will be returning today?
Yes, I've heard speculation that they will return. My bets on Ponderosa. No other speculation.
Well, the only problem with this is, this time the Mushroom Boys return, yes, it's true. But this time, on the same team, instead of against each other.
That's right. Ponderosa and Swedenhouse team up, team to team this time. Instead of against each other, like they shouldn't be, they'll be a team as one. And they'll be taking on two scrubs. We'll see plenty more. We'll see Twisted and tag team action. We'll see Andy Ponderosa and a lot more. Also, now, you must be wondering why I'm wearing this Viking hat.
I was just about to bring that up, brother.
I was going
to
mention something of it myself.
I'm wearing the Viking hat to symbolize the war, because Stranglemania 1 was ruthless, but you are going to see a war here on Stranglemania 2. You are going to see blood. You are going to see limbs. You're going to see all types of flavor. Fuck it. Let's get down to the action.
Let's go down to the ring now and wrestle.
Whoa, I can feel it in my bones, Guido. We're back.
Greedy. And you know, everybody's been waiting for it. Everybody's been feeding for it. And here it is, Stranglemania 2.
Stranglemania 2. And what better way to kick things off with the return of a Matt legend, Lama Nama Numi.
That's right, Lama Nama Numi of Death Matt. Deathmatch.
Now right here, he's going up against newcomer Hollywood Chuck Hogan. The first one to the ladder gets to use it. They're counting down in Japanese, but I'll be happy to know they're down to one. Let's go.
Who's going to get the barbed wire? Who's going to get the ladder?
Oh, neither one. Hollywood Chuck Hogan's got the ladder first.
And he puts it right upside Lama Nama Numi's head. But don't forget about the coconut crunchers. You can't destroy that head as easily as Hollywood
Lama Numi's got something in his hand. He's got something in his hand right now.
Wait. Hey, he barely even hit the ladder that time.
Nonetheless.
All right, now let me tell you something about Lama Nama Numi right now. His jeans are extra tight. He usually wears them two sizes too small. Now he's got them five sizes too small because he wants the extra tingling sensation of the loss of blood in his balls.
Well, enough for that later. Right now he's getting his face rammed in by the steel ladder by Hollywood Chuck Hogan.
Hollywood Chuck Hogan is without a doubt one of the most dangerous men here in the Wrestling Federation. Hollywood Chuck Hogan has been seen on the underground wrestling circuit for years. He was never allowed to premiere here in the Major Wrestling League, but now he's here because he's toned down his style now. He used to your balls from your penis completely. Now he just the skin.
And you know, Guido, if you know about Hollywood Chuck Hogan, you can tell he's a Hogan by the pattern. Haircut of another Hogan that
that's
he's
right.
The tip to.
Clearly shaving the top of the head, revealing he has no feelings of looks at whatsoever. He's not concerned with looks. Now, one man sitting at this panel that some of you might not have realized knows more about Hollywood Chuck Hogan than any of us. The man that's wrestled him many times, involved in many feuds with him, Luscious Johnny Stark. Johnny, tell me what is most dangerous about this newcomer. The Stranglemania fans of Stranglemania Volume 2, they want to know what it is that makes him so ruthless besides the obvious axe-like chops with the chair.
Well, it would have to be the French fibula. Hollywood Chuck Hogan has been very notarized for using that tactical maneuver. If you listen closely in the back, you'll hear the Chuckamaniacs. They've been saying their prayer and eating their Vicodins.
I want to know what the French tickler has anything to do with this match, period. I want you to speculate on what exactly that is and what we can expect to see out of Lama Nama Numi. I don't want any surprises. This is dangerous. This is not bullshit.
Well, you want to know something, 3D? I'll tell you the truth about Hollywood Chuck Hogan. Newcomer to Stranglemania, he might be, yes. But newcomer to death matches and professional wrestling,
Lama Nama Numi just peeling himself off that ladder, stuck in the face, chest,
and abdominal stretch area.
And now, Hollywood Chuck Hogan says I'm coconut first until the corner, 3D.
Now, I've seen this. I've seen him do this before on the Underground. Oh,
right in the breadbasket.
Clearly a dangerous type match. Now, you might have seen a ladder match before, but have you ever seen a barbed wire coated ladder razor death kick to the boot face match?
Many times in my career there, 3D. Many, many times.
You also notice on Lamana Manumi, he enjoys promoting himself by wearing himself on his fucking t-shirt.
Now, another reason Lamana Manumi wears the jeans, the Wrangler jeans, five sizes too tight, is to reveal that he has no hidden objects. He has been accused of using foreign objects in the past, and you don't fucking play that shit, because all you see in his jeans are two balls and a dick, because it's that tight, he might as well have been poured into those shit jeans, and that speculation is over. You know he has no foreign objects.
On top of that, he enjoys wearing the tight jeans so the bitches can see his ball outline and his meat outline in his chick jeans, because the women love his dick.
Now, Lama Namanubi has told me many times that he wears a thong. He wears a thong, thus his ass form. Enough about his ass.
They're in the crowd right now. This death match is supposed to be taking place in the ring. And there you see him hitting him in the coconut. Oh. And Lamana Manumi is not having it hit in the coconut. Coconut Cruncher, bam.
Now there he goes, ramming his Coconut Cruncher right into the rubber mat. The head of Hollywood Chuck Hogan.
Yes, refrain yourself. I don't see any rubber masks in this match, 3D.
Now I want everybody to know right now, even a veteran like Hollywood Chuck Hogan has not fully aware of the head that comes on Lamana Manumi, the head we saw send Deadly Fred into convulsions, the head we saw send Cactus Sack into kleptospasms.
The same head that put me out of my career for over 3 years.
That's right.
Johnny used to wrestle Lamana Manumi our time as his tag team partner. Lamana Manumi turned on Luscious Johnny and gave him a coconut cruncher.
Luscious Johnny,
out of commission.
You're new to the broadcast table here with me and Guido. I want you to know that I think you're man enough. I think you're a good man for mentioning that. I wasn't going to bring it up, but since you brought it up, I might as well let the cat out of the bag. He kicked your fucking ass. For 5 years, he beat your fucking ass all over the Orient. He beat your ass up and down the mountains of Hawaii, up and down the cactuses of Phoenix, up and down the fucking arch of St. Louis. He beat your fucking ass everywhere you look, east side, west side, Chicago, 3D.
Yes, if I may interject, Luscious Johnny in 3D, I would like to know, well, the people, I know all about it already, but the people at home perhaps would like to know your two wrestling backgrounds with and against each other.
Well, myself, I've been in the Federation for about 18 years.
One,
I had to take a almost a pin, but he returned. I had to take a short leave because of my alcoholism. And Lamana Manumi had put me out.
Me and Johnny, we're talking about Lamana Manumi and Hollywood Chuck Hogan. Me and Luscious Johnny Stark's wrestling career have nothing to do with this. I'm not going to talk about what happened when we wrestled each other. I'm not going to bring that up.
That has everything to do with the 3D.
That was many years ago. Don't start on me already, Guido. God damn it.
There it is. Front face, back DDT face cruncher.
That was the Falcon Dove Slam right there in the middle of the ring. Now, notice Hollywood Chuck Hogan's baseball pants, because they used to play baseball for the Cleveland A's back in 1975.
And he also likes them because they're two sizes tighter than the tights of the normal wrestling.
They're not as tight as Lamana Manumi's. Don't let him steal Lamana Manumi's trademark already. Now look at this. Right here's a perfect example that Lamana Manumi knows how to handle a man like Hollywood Chuck Hogan. He took him right out into the crowd because the ring means nothing in a death match. There you notice that Hollywood Chuck Hogan perhaps has had a few too many loaves of bread with extra butter. He's got somewhat of a love handle of whatnots around his stomach.
We won't talk about that.
Well,
right,
your environment is a great situation in a wrestling tactical maneuver, I'll have you know.
That's right. And that's no question that the death match, the environment is anywhere in the building. Now, Hollywood Chuck Hogan with a power slam.
There it goes. And if you'll notice, 3D and Luscious Johnny,
there you see
the match has been seesawing. But if you'll notice, the Hollywood Chuck Hogan has been on top for most of the match, and Lamana Manumi has been on the floor bleeding out of his coconut profusely.
Now, right there, that power slam is the very reason why Lamana Manumi has a flat ass. He could have had a very round, voluptuous ass.
We won't
no.
talk about his ass right now.
Now, watch this right here. God so help me, if he powerbombs him onto that ladder, I'm going to have to do something about it.
He's setting him up for the Norwegian closure.
Right there.
Oh, no.
Oh,
my God.
Right on the fucking ladder.
Not only did he powerbomb on the fucking ladder, but that ladder is wrapped in barbed wire.
Hit that fucking son of a bitch.
Dude.
No.
Oh, you can't so close.
And look, he's pissed off. He's jumping around like a raving retard. He's like, God damn it. One powerbomb wasn't enough. Perhaps he'll try it again.
He's going to try it again right here. He heard you. He's going to do it right here live at Stranglemania 2. No! No!
Oh, the inverted Frankensteiner right there before your eyes.
Right there before your eyes.
There it is. One, two.
Executed with complete perfection.
And if you'll notice.
There it is. Coconut crunches.
Crunchers.
Now right here, he's going to go for the. There it was.
Frontal Nelson.
It's a good thing the Hollywood Chuck Hogan has that protective layer on his face.
Now right there, Lama Nama Numi knew Hollywood Chuck Hogan was in no position to be pinned, yet he tried holding his shoulders down for real. What the hell
just happened? Did he pin him?
I beg to disagree. He in fact.
Now wait a goddamn minute.
My monitor down, I didn't see shit.
Wait a fucking minute.
Listen
what
here,
the
Donovan.
Hell was that? Wait a minute.
He Who's clearly this? Won the match.
Wait oh my minute. God, it's Rudy Mill. I knew it. Now that was clearly wrong. He did not get the pinfall. Rudy Mills, come out from the dressing room.
What is Rudy Mills doing out here? God damn it, he has no fucking business in
the
ring.
He seems to be spitefully talking
That's
to Lama
right.
Namanuni.
Now wait a minute.
He's taunting him. He's pushing him out of the fucking chest.
Rudy Mills.
They're choking each other
I
for
can't
real.
Believe what I'm seeing.
What the hell's going on here?
Rudy Mills knows that that was an unfair count. And Rudy Mills came out to justify the wrestling. And
wait, there you see Texas Toast, Terry Williams.
And also the enforcer, Tony Ankle Lip, is out in the ring right now.
Oh!
Ankle Lip gives him a Super Eagle Boy clothesline.
That right there is a Dirty Dutch Wrestler.
Oh.
Well, let's go to some other footage. God damn it. Now this right here is some classic footage, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right. You see there in the corner.
Right here from the Duck Dome, 1914, a classic match. The old timers remember these people perfectly.
That is right there
in control of the match is none other than the Fortified Hooligan.
That's right.
A great Matt legend.
And you'll see in the white right there, throwing the real punches, it would seem. That is the Masked Cabana.
Now, let me tell you something about the Masked Cabana. You mentioned that those punches look real. Johnny, now, when you began your career, they were finishing theirs. How has wrestling differed from back then till to now?
Well, I was just going to mention that. If you notice, there's a lot more aerial and legwork in wrestling of today.
Shut the fuck up. Let's get into some more present wrestling. Let's get into some more present wrestling excitement. We'll get back to this match later. I just wanted to show it to the people to show them how
fucking
styles.
Whack wrestling was back in the day.
Wrestling
this
was.
This shit is stupid. It's time to turn this shit off because it's fucking dumb.
All right, well, here you go, Guido. Here's some fucking present wrestling. Right there, the big fat stuffed faggot. That man is known as Andorino Pandorina.
I can't look at this motherfucker holding the ropes open, wearing some Bruce Jenner shorts.
Now, here goes some perfectly fine.
What the fuck is this guy doing? He's stupid as fuck, and people are patting his Ultraman head.
Guido, please. Now
this pisses me off when I see stupid fucks come in the ring doing head springs.
This is a great matchup, classic matchup from today's wrestling styles.
Oh, the fucking panda bear faggot attacks Ultraman.
Now Ultra Bitch is clearly not in top physical form because it's obviously cloudy outside today at the Nipple Arena.
Yes, it's true. There's no sun out. There seems to be an overcast, and you can see that Ultra Puss is clearly not in the best condition he could be in.
Now, the fact of the matter is, whether he's in good condition or poor condition, the fact of the matter is that the fat guy in the panda bear suit looks like a big, fat, cuddly faggot. And I don't know what the fuck we're even doing watching this bullshit fucking match.
I don't know. But
there's not even any goddamn thumbtacks in this motherfucker.
I don't know who's responsible for putting it out. This asshole in the fucking bear suit's making me mad. 3D.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry. Let's get into some more wrestling footage.
I'm going down there. I'm zipping that fucking zip on his back, pull him out of the bear suit, and kicking his fucking balls in so he can't fuck men no more.
Now, let's go on back to some more. I'm sorry about this. It was a mix-up in the library.
All right, here we go. Newcomer to the Stranglemania.
Newcomer to Stranglemania, Guido, but he is not a newcomer to professional wrestling, and he is not
That's
a newcomer
right.
to the deathmatch.
And sweet baby bitch in the white. Squaring up against asshole Andy Armageddon with the kabuki face.
Now, until we brung it to Stranglemania, asshole Andy Armageddon has just been a rumor. Asshole Andy Armageddon has just been speculatively existing.
And
but
if you notice, Armageddon's got the forearm protectors with the spikes coming off it so he can ram it in people's faces and knock them out. And on top of that, Armageddon's got people outside of the ring with the press. You'd like to tell the wrestling fans watching Stranglemania now who the fuck they are, 3D.
Now there goes, he just got an item from his manager, Lonesome Chicky Star, and he's gonna use it right now in the ring. Now listen, as I was saying before you rudely cut me off, asshole Andy Armageddon has been a rumor, almost a phantom in the wrestling world, Johnny.
It's true.
People have not thought he existed because he's only wrestled in the underworld. He's only wrestled in the illegal after-hour bars of Japan, and he has never wrestled on the main circuit. But we have brought him forth, and we have put him against a well-loved pansy little bitch. And I'm talking about Sweet Baby Bitch.
That's right. Sweet That's Baby true. Bitch is known for his fucking tactics of crying in the ring and trying to fiddle with men's balls.
Sweet Baby Bitch often cries like a newborn woman on several occasions in the middle of the ring. That's because he's over-emotional. But now he has to put his emotions aside and get his strategies together because he is going up against what has been feared for the last 107 years. And I'm talking about Armageddon, asshole Andy Armageddon.
3D, I'd like to bring up a fact right now. But it's not really a fact, it's speculation. I'd like to speculate on right now that fucking Sweet Baby Bitch, perhaps maybe we've seen before in a stupid faggot panda bear suit.
That's clearly speculation. That, in fact, was spectacular Tony Vassaro that you've seen in the panda suit.
That's not for anybody to speculate.
Oh, my God, you see him. Ram upside Andy Kettin's head.
I'd like
with
to make
metal
a
chair.
Point.
I'd
I
like
want to... Go ahead, Johnny.
All right, well, if you notice, Triple A has a heavy metal descent to him with the King Diamond Kabuki face paint and the metal Iron Mike Shark wristbands, if you will.
Listen to me. The reason I brung this match, aside of what you guys are discussing right now here at Strangomania, the reason I brung this match and I wanted to show the people this match is I wanted to just make a point right now that Sweet Baby Bitch is a fan favorite, a baby-faced little bitch.
Well, this is true.
Now, he does not break the rules of wrestling. He is a great competitor, amateur style. And on the opposite side of the ring, you've got asshole Andy Armageddon, and he is the ultimate rule breaker. And this is the ultimate match of good versus bad, goddammit.
And also, if you notice too, 3D and Luscious Johnny, for some stupid fucking reason, asshole Andy Armageddon, whatever the fuck, Armageddon, he doesn't have shoes on for some strange reason.
He doesn't have shoes on because he likes to kick with the heel. His heels, now as Johnny will tell you, both of his heels have been reconstructive surgeried on and they have lead implants into the heel area.
Well, actually it's a lead and plastic based product that builds up the ankle.
Wait
to
a
the
second.
Hip bone.
Hold on a minute. I just seen Brutus the Butcher Beefcake out there.
That was Brutus the Butcher. He is resurfacing in the foundation, and he will be back
right there.
In
another
later.
Weapon. There it is. There it is. The hand claw given him by his manager, Lonesome Chicky Star. He has got the hand claw now. This is where the match comes to an end. See, now Sweet Baby Bitch
that
has no
totally
idea.
That is totally uncalled for. That
hey,
is
digging into the back of Sweet Baby Ass.
Sweet Baby Bitch.
I can't believe this.
Sweet Baby Bitch expected a fair grappling match.
Look at
but
this.
What he got
he
is
pulled
this.
The flesh off his back.
I would have never allowed anything like that in my days of refereeing.
Well,
let me
tell
you
something. Back in the day when you used to wrestle, you were a pussy. Everybody that wrestled were pussies. Nowadays, they wrestle with ninja claw weapons.
Right there, the ninja claw tearing into the back area of Sweet Baby Bitch. Sweet Baby Bitch is in trouble for one reason. He did not expect it to happen. He did not expect fucking asshole Andy.
Oh my God!
The poor man is crying for God's sake.
Oh
where
my
is he
God!
Coming
in the
with
face!
This?
Right in the
face! That is uncalled for!
Jeez.
Where the hell is the ref on this?
Oh my God, look at it sticking into his back!
That little son of a bitch!
My God.
That fucking son of a bitch outside, Lonesome Chicky Star, has been handing him weapons through this whole match. Now there you have the sickle, the fucking Kama sickle, sticking right into the.
He put it right into his heart!
Adding injury to insult already. This is ridiculous.
He's gonna fucking kill him 3D.
He's
now right here,
death.
Right here is something that I did not expect. I thought that fucking Nepple Nitten or whatever the fuck his name is was gonna have some kind of a heart in going up against Sweet Panty Bitch.
No man.
Sweet Baby Balls came into this match not knowing it was a death match. When he came in, asshole Armageddon, started pulling out the ninja weapons and beating him with them.
No man should withstand that many blows to the breadbasket without bleeding so profusely.
Now listen, Sweet Baby Balls had no idea what was going to happen when he climbed into the ring. He was stupid. That's the only thing I can say. Everybody's heard the rumors since you were boys at camp. You've heard the rumors about Rusty Nipple Nedden and the tactics he brings to the ring. And now you're seeing it. You're not just hearing the rumors.
Yeah, well.
A barbed wire bat, goddammit.
There you see. Going for it. Going for it. The barbed wire biscuit. Yes, again.
and he hits him across the back. I don't see why he don't take a full swing
this
on his face.
In my opinion,
Guido,
right now.
In my opinion, Guido, oh, in my opinion, God. Luscious, is sweet, sweet, sour itch is a total fucking moron for not expecting this.
I agree, he may be provoking it, but that is totally uncalled
for. This motherfucker outside of the ring, Lonesome Chicken Star, he keeps handing these deadly weapons, he's gonna fucking kill somebody.
That's exactly what I've been trying to tell you, Guido. When they were wrestlers on the underground circuit, the illegal underworld of wrestling, that's exactly what they did was kill people. That's why they're so legendary at being ruthless and dangerous.
Well, I'll tell you something. Sweet Baby Bitch was never no underground nothing. He's been a little fucking pansy asshole bitch his whole fucking life. And you'll see, he's...
Oh! He got the bat out of his hands! Sweet Baby Pamper Balls has got the spiked bat, and now he's gonna wrap it around the fucking dick and pussy of Andy Armageddon.
And you're right, he scraped it right across the fucking pussy.
That's right, in case some of you didn't know it, Andy Armageddon is a hermaphrodite. He does have a pussy hole underneath his nuts. Not to discuss his personal problems or benefits, as some might see it, he does have a vagina underneath his dick.
Right, right there, he gave him a DDT and didn't even hold it. Fucking go, that stupid asshole fucking asshole. Stupid fucking asshole Andy Armageddon just went right down to the fucking mat like a dumbass.
Oh, there we go.
Now, if you notice, he's swinging pretty gingerly with that baseball bat.
Sweet foul!
Oh,
the green mist!
Green
the green mist of poisonous gas!
And we've seen that twice so far in this match, and yet for a third time.
They're
right
gonna float some chicky dick, handing. Oh! He caught him! He distracted him right there.
He hit him right in the fucking face with a chair and fuck distracting him.
Now, who's got the burning bat? Once again, it's Sweet Fluffy Balls hitting him with that spike bat, hitting Armageddon in the fucking fat pussy gut.
That's right, fucking Fluffy Rabbit Ass has got the flaming fucking barbed wire bat. And what's he gonna do with it, 3D? Luscious Johnny.
Oh, what right into the stomach.
Yes. Luscious Johnny.
Yes?
I need to know what your analyzation. Oh my God.
More green mist.
I heard, Luscious Johnny, you know the ingredients in that green mist spew, and I want to know what the hell's in it.
I'm not at liberty to give that information
away. Give us the
away.
Goddamn information, Johnny!
Actually, it's green food coloring, but you didn't hear that from me.
Maybe we can edit that out afterwards.
Sorry.
All right, anyway, now, look at this right here. Now you're seeing Armageddon with the bat on the floor, ramming pansy balls into it. Sweet Baby Bitch had no idea what was coming, and now he's out for the count.
One.
I'll guarantee you that.
He
pulled him up. He pulled that fucking pansy faggot little bitch balls off the mat. Now he's going to swing him into the ropes and rip him in the face with that fire barbed wire.
Oh,
that's
my
hot.
God.
That's hot.
And that's hot.
One, two, three. There he gets him. Sweet dog balls. Doesn't fucking hold a chance when it comes to death matches. He used to fucking having pussy matches where he fights feeble women,
skinny women. My, Guido, how wrestling has changed from the 1920s. Let's go back to our Matt Classic right now. Look at the flying, or the Mascabana going up against...
Flying Filippio.
The fucking Fortified Hooligan.
Yes,
there
true.
He is. Now, the Fortified Hooligan wearing the black spandex is using karate chops.
Karate. And you can obviously tell that
right upside
the fucking banner is getting his ass whipped.
There's his manager right there.
That's right.
That is the manager of the Masked Cabana.
None other than Wolf Puckerstaff.
No, you're wrong. That was his manager in the 30s. Right here was manager Vinny Stefienko. Enough of that. Let's get back to some more present day footage.
He fell on his own fucking head. This is stupid.
We'll return to this fucking old bullshit later on. Let's get back into this. Now here we got Power Boy. Power Boy and Scott.
And they're going up against the big return of the Mushroom Boys.
Ponderosa and Sweethouse making their way down to the barbed wire circle.
The two fat, sweaty, lovable butterballs are back in the circuit.
You either want to grab their fat chunks and squeeze and hug them, or you want to cuddle up with them in the fucking Arctic nights.
Hey.
Nonetheless, they're fat and jelly bags.
I don't want either of those fucking options, greedy, and I wouldn't appreciate you bringing me up in your secret fetishes with fat people.
Such a fucking hole. Now, here we are in the middle of the match. Look at Sweethouse screaming like a newborn woman.
Yes, and you can see him still shitting his pants. Listen.
He's so
fucking scared. Bitch.
Now let's talk about Power Boy. Let the fans know. I'll tell you about Power Boy. Power Boy is a fucking stupid fucking asshole wearing a Power Ranger suit and he fucking sucks.
That's right. And if you'll notice, his partner, Scott, has got to be one of the fucking out of shape, lame-ass, wackest fucking wrecks I've ever seen in my life.
Let me tell you something about Scott Guido. If his biker shorts were any tighter, you'd see the veins in his dick. Ow! Oh my God.
I can't believe that you just said that.
I didn't say
Look,
that.
Just because he's wearing poop pumps don't mean you can stare at his dick 3D.
Now, Luscious Johnny, tell me how the Barbed Wire affects the loopy fat of Sweeten House.
Well, it cuts through the layers of cellulite in a painful fashion.
All right. Now, look at Power Boy, that fucking asshole.
Change the camera angle. I don't want to look at those two fucking asses.
Power Boy's got a fucking $12 Walmart Halloween costume. Oh!
That's right. He got his whole wrestling outfit and came in a plastic bag. He opened the top, pulled it out, strapped it on, and walked down to the ring with Scott.
Look at this right here. Scott's the one in the biker shorts. Scott looks, you know, he looks like shit. That fucking idiot. These are jobbers, ladies and gentlemen. We can't deny it, Guido. No. We can't deny it. After all, this is Stranglemania 2.
Settle down, goddammit.
Stranglemania 2.
You want to notice something here?
What?
Fat ass fucking piece of fucking fat flop of fuck Sweeten House and his partner Butterball ass fucking Ponderosa. Now
watch this right here. Listen. Listen right here closely. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, to the pain. Listen.
Wait a second. Power Boy's grabbing his balls from the back. That's why Dunbar screams of pain. Dunbar screams of enjoyment.
Great fucking camera work by camera work number three. Cameraman number three, Harvey,
crippled tail. Now, if you notice something, like I was saying before, 3D.
Slow motion on the barbed wire to the neck area.
Is that my
Luscious mind? Johnny, back yes. in your day of wrestling, did they stick the barbed wire into the mouth like they're doing right now on fat ass Ponderosa?
I'm gonna have to say never in the mouth or tongue area, no.
Where did they stick the barbed wire?
Usually
was it only in the pits of an anus, or was it actually around the genitals as well?
Around the ass cheek area, never in the cracks, slowly towards the bottom.
All right.
I've also heard that back in the day they didn't really use barbed wire, so you must have been using something else. Go back to the match now.
Right there, a fucking powerbomb by Sweeten House. Now he's
trying to fuck him. He's got him in the book.
Right there, he's dry humping Scott.
That's right, Scott has dune streaks in his poom pooms.
That's disgusting.
Well, what do you want, goddamn? I'm not the one dying there trying fucking his
barbed wire. Right there, into the barbed wire. Right there.
Back like
a weak looking clothesline. Scott looks like he came to the match riding a mountain bike
now,
and not as a wrestler.
Back to what I was saying 10 minutes ago, and I kept getting rudely interrupted. Now, Ponderosa and Sweeten House are very good at fighting each other, but for some reason, whenever I see them fight anybody else, including losers like
right
Powerboy and Scott, they get their fucking asses whipped.
Right there, you can clearly see the barbed wire wasn't even hitting his arm. Scott has no idea what he's doing in the ring. For Christ's sake, he's got leg warmers on. Get that fucking pansy faggot out of the ring and get some real competition for Sweeten House and Ponderosa.
Now, I want to bring something up, 3D, that we haven't brought too much up in this match right now.
What?
If you'll notice the fucking the large exteriors, you might want to say, of the fat fucking mushroom asses.
Both of these gentlemen look like big, loopy bags, sandwich bags of brown water to me.
That's true. Now, Luscious Johnny, perhaps you could give your input on your opinion of the athletic shape of the Mushroom Boys.
I feel for as large and great mass of people that they are, they're very skilled and agile for fat pieces of shit.
Well, I'd like to bring a large friend of mine to give me a demonstration. I'd like to bring him to the table, if you don't mind, Guido. I'd like to bring him to the table. He can tell me what it's like being a wrestler as a large man. Please welcome 475-pound Big Grim Tim from Barrel Saga, Mississippi. Grim Tim, how you doing?
Howdy-o.
Now, you're a large man, and you've been wrestling on the independent scene there in Saga, Mississippi. Tell me about what it's like wrestling with your large frame.
Well, I haven't had too many matches. I fought Marvelous Marty Milkweight in my first bout last Sunday.
Oh, so you've just become a wrestler.
Well,
tell me about
training.
What it's like maneuvering your fat ass in the ring. Is it harder? Is it your advantage? Is it a disadvantage? Tell the listeners of Funkamania.
Well, I wrestle in nothing but my red panties and a pair of boots. So it's pretty much agileness, and I have a slight tactical advantage.
What's that?
Oh my boots.
All right. Enough of that. Back to the match. Sweethouse tries climbing the top rope and falls off, just like he always does because he's fat and he's greasy like a big fat fucking bulb of potato shit.
Once again, Sweethouse making a fool out of himself here at Stranglemania. Now look at that big round ball of melted fucking shit. That's what they both look like. Two big fat balls of shit wrapped in a fucking white blanket. Both of them.
Big fat fucking piece of shit, round saucers of warm pudding.
And they're fucking so slippery, sweaty, and fat that I can't lie. I wish I could strip down naked
3D?
And slide all over their fat stomach.
Hold on
a second.
Wait. 3D, it looks like he's going for your patented move, the flying jalapeno.
There it is!
Oh.
He landed it right on Scott.
Two and three. He got the
That's
pin.
The way to take
it once
home.
Once again, the Mushroom Boys victorious. Let's go back to our vintage footage once again.
And you'll see the Masked Cabana getting his ass whipped by the Fortified Hooligan.
The Fortified Hooligan was a dangerous competitor, one of the first.
Now you'll notice the concern of the manager up on the apron.
Yes, the manager is up on the apron. He's looking at his boy get his fucking ass beat.
He's getting hit by real karate.
Now here comes Valerius Vinny Stefienko dragging the Masked Cabana back into the corner.
Let's see what he's got to say.
Let's get some camera work and see what they're saying right now. Listen.
What's the matter with him? I swear, he's trying to kill you.
That fellow's not the Black Mask. He's been using karate on me. And he could kill me with one blow.
Listen, I'll ask that they suspend the match, Samson.
No, I'm going to see this thing through to the end.
But you're crazy. He's trying to murder you.
I've already been warned about this.
Vinny Stefienko, leave him alone and let the Masked Cabana do what he does best, and that's wrestling. Now there's a champion. Now you don't see that kind of sportsmanship in wrestling today.
See, he clearly thought it was the Black Mask, and it was a Fortified.
Back to some present wrestling. Now I still that even the next we're going to see drunk Terry Funk, even though he's 95 years old, he doesn't possess that kind of willpower in the ring.
And
there he is.
Who the fuck is this asshole he's with?
A nobody. We're not even going to bring up his fucking jobber partner.
He's got a stupid fucking red patch in his head.
Looks like a fucking, looks like Scott again, only wearing some red briefs.
It appears he, oh my God.
Here they come.
It's
the total package, Freddy Luger and his partner, Scary Woody. This is twisted.
And he's scaring the shit out of the crowd, even though he ain't no bigger than a normal ninja.
There's Scary Woody.
Scary Woody.
Scary Woody is fucking absolutely, unbelievably dangerous. His partner, the Total Package Freddy Luger, collectively known as Twisted, they have terrorized the Japanese streets since they came out in 1992.
And there he is, 98-year-old drunk Terry Funk, hitting him with those weak-ass old punches on the masked face of the Total Package Freddy Luger and Scary Woody.
His body looks like soft, watery felt because he's so old. He looks like a fucking eggplant more than he does a wrestler.
He looks like a sun-dried prune. He looks like a meat in cold water.
And there he is wearing the disco stripes and
he just did the spinning neck twister spin.
His muscles have turned into melted silly putty.
That's right.
Still a wrestler. There he's got the Total Package Freddy Luger into the ropes. And oh, they both collide. They're both stunned. Guido, they're both stunned.
That's right. But no, not stunned enough. Here it is. There it is.
The double wind
crab
up.
Crunch.
The double wind up. The chicken crab crunch. He's got it on. Oh, no.
Wait.
Scary Woody. The same thing. Crab crunch. It's all over, Guido. It's all over. Oh my God.
Total package.
Back to Freddy Luger.
He's signaling for it.
It's over.
There it is. The cricket crab crunch.
I want to go to something new right now because this is wrapped up. Let's go to something brand new. Right here, joined in progress. Two women wrestling each other
3D.
In the bar wire.
3D.
Yes.
Luscious Johnny.
Yes.
Now this shit right here is something that's never been seen on national television like it is today.
Before we even begin discussing the politics of this match, let it be known. I'd probably fuck the fat chick, but I'd fuck the shit out of that young one.
Let me tell you
I'd bend her in so many styles. She thinks she knows how to wrestle. I'd bend her fucking knees behind her head and stick her head up her ass and roll her back and forth across my butt.
That's all fine and dandy, 3D. But that fat bitch's name, she's none other than Asshole Andy Armageddon's little sister.
Asshole Andy Armageddon's little sister.
Sweaty Nedden Armageddon.
Sweaty Nedden Armageddon.
And then Oh, my God.
The electrified fence
right
of death.
Right off the bat.
Now, that little sexy bitch has got her fucking asshole shocked. That is sweet sugar ass.
Sweet sugar ass versus... What's that?
Sweaty fucking loopy net nut again.
And
now, I want to bring some... Hold on, Lucius Johnny. I want to bring something up right here.
Okay.
Now, God damn it. This fat bitch with the red fucking mohawk. She looks like she might be asshole Andy Armageddon. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, well, much like her brother, Triple A, she is also skilled in the exciting Tahitian toehold potato wedge.
That's right. She does have that movement. Oh, right there is my...
She's covering the crotch.
And I do that to her right down on my living room floor and fuck the shit out of her.
Two, three.
Now, wait a minute.
So close.
I'm not saying that right there. I'm not saying that sweet... What's her name? Sweet sexy ass. Sweet... Tell her, get the fucking
sweet,
name,
Guido. Sweet sexy ass package.
Sweet sexy ass. I'm not saying that sweet sexy ass is the most unbelievably stacked woman. Her ass does look like a fucking cookie sheet, but I definitely fuck her nonetheless.
Her ass looks somewhat like somebody stuffed a shoebox
lining
down the back
up
of her pants.
That's right. Now there it goes, the airplane spin throbble neck squeezer.
That's right. And there goes, she got her legs open for everybody to enjoy peaks and views of her net.
There, right there, you're getting a good look at a fat dyke. Right there.
Let
with
me
the fucking hair and the fat holes and the poopy titties.
I don't give a fuck what you say, 3D, and I don't give a fuck what you say, Lusus Johnny. Whoa. As far as I'm concerned, that's asshole Andy Armageddon.
It could very well be asshole Andy Armageddon, but Andy Armageddon can handle himself in a ring with men. He doesn't have to come in the ring and wrestle this skinny little bitch. I mean, come on. What would somebody like me or you do to that bitch in a real fight? I'd peel her fucking bikini off and squeeze her nipples and twist them like I'm tuning a guitar amp.
It looks to me like that's the killer camel toe hold she's getting ready to apply. Yes, it is.
Right there.
She's holding it up in the air. The referee's going to pull her pants down and fuck her.
Now, right there, before we get carried away in the amateur skills we're seeing, let it be known the ring is wrapped in barbed wire, and if you hit the barbed wire, an electric shock will fry the insides of your netting, being a woman that they are. It would just tickle your balls if you're a man, because it's a less charge. It only frizzles your nut hairs. But to them, it'll completely bake the hair pie.
This bitch with a stupid fucking red piece on top of a fat piece of fucking dyke fat floppy shithead. I fucking hate her.
Now it's very well known fat chicks know how to fucking give good head.
Oh my God, so close. But she hits the baseball sign.
Sends
the fat bitch right to the barbed
wire. Her ass is smoking.
I think it's the... There he is.
Sweet baby bitch. Sweet baby bitch is the... It's well-known sweet baby bitch is sweet sugar ass's boyfriend. Now, he is ringside crying like a pansy little bitch.
That's right. You can see the tears running down his stupid fucking face.
Fuck. Why are you letting your fine-looking bitch wrestle in this match? She's going to come back looking like Freddy Luger, all scarred up and charred up and fucking ugly. And you're still going to fuck her, you sick bastard, because you're a wrestler.
I want to bring something up. Perhaps you can help me with this, Luscious Johnny Stark.
All right.
Why the fuck is that stupid referee wearing goggles?
Well, that's because earlier there was an in-tank swimming fish hole match. And it's carried on through. There you see her getting ready to set up for the cubic punch.
Look at that piece of flesh. Hanging off her ass, connected to the ropes.
Oh, God.
What ass?
Oh, that big shoebox in her fucking ass.
Her ass looks like a fucking ironing board sideways, long and flat. But I'd nonetheless stick my dick right in between them.
There you see Sweaty Nedden trying to free loose and get the areola.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry, but I want to bring another guest to the table if I can.
Sure.
We have a female wrestler. She comes from St. Paul, Minnesota. Her name is Jenny. Jenny's going to tell us all about what it's like wrestling when you've got the weight of two fat jelly bags of titty hanging off your chest
and one big fat jelly bag hanging off your stomach.
Now, Jenny is a female wrestler with large breasts, and she's going to tell us what the aerialistics are different than being a male wrestler as being a women wrestler, whatever.
And
Jenny,
also the areola-istics.
And the areola, and how the areola feels when it's charged by electrified barbed wire. Jenny, please tell us about wrestling with your titties.
I'm not a wrestler.
Jenny.
Yeah?
Fucking tell them about what it's like wrestling when you're a woman and you've got titties. Tell them.
You mean like Chuck Hogan?
You're a stupid fat fucking bitch. You
get the fuck out of here.
I don't wrestle.
Get out of here, bitch.
Stop grabbing my hair.
I fucking told her. I'm sorry, Guido.
Stupid fuck. I hate you for bringing that bitch in.
I'm sorry. Now look, right there. You see that standard position right there?
That's right.
That's how I bend her over my bed and bang her box out right from behind.
That's called the reversal neck buster.
That's right. Now that chick right there, in this match right here, you'll notice that Andy Armageddon's younger sister,
Sweaty Ned and Armageddon.
Sweaty Ned and Armageddon has got the weight advantage, if you will.
Well, she's a big, fat fucking bitch.
She's got the weight advantage, and you look at the little, frail, jumping bomb angel type young lady that's going to probably get her fucking ass kicked.
If you want to know something, we actually joined this match in progress.
She was like,
throwing her, she's too fat. She couldn't walk no more.
She whispered in the other girls, I ain't taking that bump, bitch. Fuck you. You
know, like I was saying, they joined the match in progress.
Look at that CT.
Where before it, she gave her a fucking inverted atomic leg buster on the fucking barbed wire and ripped one of her pant legs off.
Now, a lot of the viewers a lot of our more observant viewers will notice the CT on Sweaty Ned and Armageddon's uniform. That means cock tease, because she's a dyke. She doesn't like dicks. She rubs on your cock. I'm sorry, Green, I gotta bring out the facts.
Well, let me tell you something.
I'm a sportscast journalist. She rubs on your cock and then goes and fucks another fat chick just like herself.
I wouldn't let that bitch rub on my cock for fucking all the money in the world and fucking all the fucking skins in the world.
Right there, right there. Sunset flip, clear as day.
And I would walk up and fuck her just like that.
Right there, the position right there, I'd just start rubbing on that.
And look at, I clearly see the ref slip his fingers into her asshole.
God damn it. Shut up, Guido. You didn't see that? Quit pointing allegations. That's when we caught the lawsuits from Stunger Mania 1.
Look at, there it goes again.
Oh. Right there, reverse.
Oh, DDT front back necker.
That was
open
called
the face
move.
Burrito slam.
Yes, open face burrito slam executed perfectly by Sexy L's sexy sugar ass.
That's
sexy
right.
Sexy sassafras sugar ass. If you look here, this bout reminds me of a similar bout with Sandy Richter and the Fabulous Molehead.
That's right.
Back in the archives when I was merely a rookie.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Stranglemania 2, the first time you have ever witnessed women wrestling in barbed wire electrified death matches. Guido, tell them how long they've been doing this and why they do it so rarely.
Oh my God, her jewels broke her neck. Well, I'll tell you, 3D. God damn it, this is Strangle fucking Mania 2. And these bitches, this fat bitch, I don't know how long she's been wrestling, because I think she used to be a fucking man. She used to go by the name Asshole Andy Armageddon.
Quit speculating that!
She's rubbing the net in profusely.
Ow, she sure is.
I noticed some color in the arm.
Sweet ass fucking sugar ass, whatever the fuck her stupid name is. Now this bitch, she's been wrestling since back in the days of fucking rockin' wrestling. She was a rockin' wrestler.
It's true.
Yes, and she used to rock and roll and wrestle at the same time.
Now, right there is the abdominal praying mantis slam.
And look, she's trying to fuck her because she's got a dick.
She doesn't have a dick. She actually has a strap on, but nonetheless, that has nothing to do with the match. Now, there you go again. There you see. Also stands for crooked titties, because one of her titties has a nipple that faces the left instead of right out at you. I've seen her shirtless. She walks around in the dressing room with one nipple looking at you, the other nipple looking at the fire extinguisher on the wall.
That's
to her left.
She's got nipples on the side of her titties instead of front, and they call her cross titties, cross-eyed titties.
Well, she's actually the widow of famous wrestler Bart Hangnail Wagner.
Oh, my God.
There it was.
Two. Cover.
No.
He's so close.
Now, listen to me, Guido. Listen to me fucking carefully.
That fucking bitch.
Sweet baby bitch is sitting ringside watching his wife receive a beating
by a fucking other man.
By a man dressed as a woman. He has got to be feeling this right now. It has to hurt inside. He's sitting ringside. And look at how good that bitch looks. After this match, she's going to look.
Oh, wait, a reversal.
A reversal.
Two. Enter. No.
Almost a sunset.
Now, right there, sweet, sexy ass just realized why they call her Sweaty Ned. She found out the hard way.
She got a face full of Ned.
God damn it.
Right,
right in her mouth. The fucking love muff was in her fucking teeth.
Now, the spandex is holding a lot of the apparent weight into Armageddon.
I've seen it before.
Sweaty Ned naked looks more like a pile of whipped cream
There you see her conjuring the power of her clam hole.
What's going on here?
No, no, don't do it.
She's going to suplex her into the
barbell. I sense a reversal. I sense a reversal, goddammit. There it is.
There, oh, no.
No, no. Almost it's going to be ugly. Oh. Right there. There she came with a left hook. No, no, hit the ropes.
No, no.
Unbelievable. Watch this.
Yes.
Oh, my God. No must I remember. Reminds you stupid fucking assholes. These are two bitches.
Now, why do you always have to disrespect us when you get excited, Guido?
Because I don't fucking know. I fucking see two bitches.
Sweet bitch ass fading out.
Shut your fucking mouth.
Guido,
I see
please.
Two bitches rolling around a fucking barbed wire, and it makes my fucking blood red.
Tom Dub.
Wait a second. No.
Tom Dub, get Guido something to drink.
God damn it.
Now, listen. Right. Oh, there he is. God damn it.
He's in
tears. He's got to be feeling that. Jesus. He has got to be feeling that. That's real, ladies and gentlemen. That is sweet, sexy ass, his boyfriend, sweet bitch ass.
His wife right is there. Putting her life on the line to bring home the bacon in that family, and he's in tears.
Well, sweet bitch ass, sweet bitch ass, and sweet sexy ass together have been a item personally, well known. The public knows all about it here in Ephinus, Japan. They know all about it, that they are a couple and they're in love, and this has got to be tearing him up emotionally, Guido.
Well, as Luscious Johnny was saying, they're here to bring home the bacon. But if they're going for bacon, my guess is going to go to Sweaty Nettin. It appears she eats a little too much bacon and swine and pork products properly greased.
There. Well, it's a well-known fact that she has to have a slab of raw hog before every match and a side of lettuce and bacon grits before every dinner.
She's conjuring the power of the clam hole. She's mustering all her power into one fist.
Sweaty Nettin is the master of the clam hold, suffocating opponents and ending their careers in the ring.
That's right, the legendary clam hold.
I wouldn't mind a clam hold from Sexy Nettin, though. Or Sexy Sweet, not Sexy, the skinny bitch, goddammit.
Let me tell you something about the clam hold. The clam hold has been around for many years, and her mother taught her that hold. Back in the day, her mother, Stanky Nettin.
No, her mother's name is Clammy Cleopatra, the clitoris queen. She comes from Uganda, and she is one of the headhunters, Kamala's younger sister's brother.
And she also holds on the clams.
She may be setting up for a cross-arm breaker there, I don't know.
If this move goes as I see correctly, the match could be over right here. There it was!
Now she's going for the bitch got power. Two, three.
A very now Guido, Guido.
That fat bitch took the ref out.
Guido, that was a very dangerous position, and I'm sure her husband knows it sitting ringside. Given that position, she gave Armageddon a perfect example, a perfect opportunity to put her in the clam hold.
3D. What? Any position you put her in could be dangerous. She could bust out with a barbed wire and strike it across your balls at any moment.
Now right there, look at that. Sexy ass is having trouble standing on those feeble legs. Look at those feeble fucking legs. She's got the LA Gear pink knee pads on.
Them aren't knee pads at all. Them are leggy warmers.
Jittery.
Now I happen to know that Sexy ass shaves her muff in order for this match.
I hear Sweaty Nettin has a super wild push.
Right Sexy here, it looks like it's so, I was like,
oh my God!
Hold on!
I she didn't see what I just out. Seen, did
Hold
I?
Hold the fuck up! Play that again! God damn it! What the fuck was that? Here it is again!
Oh my God! Her neck has to be broken.
Oh,
holy
God.
Shit!
There it is again!
Oh! In my 13 years of wrestling, never have I withstand a move like that. Oh my God!
Oh my God! I can't fucking believe what I'm saying! The neck is broken!
Oh my
Holy
God.
Fuck!
There you see Sexy Ass Sassafras looking over the damage that she's done. I don't know what to do. She doesn't know what to do. Guido, what would you do?
Shut the fuck up! Did you mother?
She's bleeding to death internally through the neck area.
Did you see what happened to the neck? All that weight, ladies and gentlemen, Strangomania fans, all that weight. Oh my God.
What's this? Hold it up.
She's gonna put her in the clam cricket slam right here.
Oh my God.
she broke her neck once, and then she broke her neck twice.
It's over!
Three count.
Without a doubt.
Let me tell you something. When you get power bound, your knees aren't supposed to fucking touch the ground. Back to the classics match, ladies and gentlemen.
I smell a spine reconstruction.
Let's see the conclusion of this.
Holy shit.
Here we got the fortified hooligan going toe-to-toe with the Masked Cabana. We've got to see that. Look at that karate chumps left and right. Now the Masked Cabana is responding with some karate of his own.
They fight like women. And look at his manager, the concern.
His manager, Vinitachi, Steffi Yoko, is very
he pulled the mask off.
You're masking?
We'll now see who the Masked Cabana is.
No, he won't. The Masked Cabana has had that mask on for 14 years, and he is not about to let it go. A reversal.
Oh,
now let's see who the fortified hooligan is. Cabana
is going to talk about the fortified hooligan using karate. The Masked Cabana is doing a good job of himself as doing karate.
He's now going for the mask.
I smell a revealing here.
Let's see who the fortified hooligan is, because Cabana has finally turned the situation around, and he's pulling the mask off.
Who is he going to be?
Ladies and gentlemen,
Cabana.
On the edge of your seat, it's the Wolfman! Oh my God! What the fuck the hell is that?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a fucking werewolf!
There's a
he's
running rapid, giving everyone standing karate chops!
Ladies and gentlemen, the police are in the ring! Oh my God, it's a fucking werewolf!
He's karate chopping the police's faces!
What
the
fuck?
Oh my God! It's Cabana!
It's a fucking werewolf!
The fans are going crazy! This is why you've never seen this footage. It has been obtained by the police, but we at Stranglemania have acquired the footage, and you're witnessing it. It hasn't been seen for 75 years. They're pulling out their guns. Oh, my God.
They shot him.
I can't believe he's a
werewolf. He had no effect.
He has a werewolf revival.
He will not be stopped.
It's a bet.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's gone.
Jesus Christ, let's go to our main event. I can't believe it.
Oh, my God.
That was one of the stupidest fucking things I've ever seen in my fucking life.
Greedy, how's your heart?
Guido, I acquired that footage myself. And you're going to go ahead on National Stranglevision, and you are going to call it stupid. You realize
I can't believe that.
He just turned into a fucking bat.
I've never seen such a display of fucking stupid shit in my life.
You didn't see the karate blow?
A fucking werewolf that gets shot and then turns into a bat. That's not believable.
Guido,
shut! That's not even wrestling.
Shut your fucking cocksucker!
Damn it, 3D, would you turn his mic off?
Shut your fucking cocksucker too, Luscious! This is the main event! Drunk Terry Flunk, 114 years old, is going up against asshole Andy Armageddon in an exploding ring match.
Yes, the late that's right. Great son of Rocky Montoya, asshole Armageddon, in this match ready to rip shit up.
And I'll tell you guys something. You hit the fucking hammer nail right on the fucking shaft there. You hit it right on the fucking girth, 3D, because those motherfucking barbed wire pieces outside of the ring, they explode.
Oh, really?
Now, wait a minute. Right here would be a good opportunity to take a look at asshole Andy Armageddon and make the call whether or not that's sweaty Nettie Armageddon. Now, I'm going to go with this speculation right here. I'm going to go ahead and say that asshole Andy Armageddon has a pussy underneath his balls, and he can easily switch to a woman just by hiding his penis into his pussy, and next thing you know, he's a woman. He can wear spandex trunks, and you can't see the lump.
Yes.
Very well could be true, but see, I
or
was training.
Or he simply hides his penis in his butt. Same difference.
Now, in my 13 years of being a wrestler, I trained along him and along the side of Terry Triple Nipple Williams, and I can guarantee you that he is all hermaphrodite all day.
All right. Drunk Terry Flunk.
This fucking match sucks.
Drunk Terry.
What?
I want to look at something one more time if you guys don't mind.
All right, all right.
Just one more time here for our viewers at Stranglemania 2. Let's
Ladies
look at this
gentlemen.
One more time. Sweaty Nettin taking it to the neck with all her fat ass.
Oh!
Oh, one more time.
Oh!
Oh! Look at this, Guido. Watch this.
Oh, my God. Look as the neck bends into the chest area. Totally not human.
Holy
I'm sorry.
Shit. Let's get back to the main event, Guido. I'm sorry. I had to.
He's going
to
throw him in the bombs.
No, he's not. Flunk is too fucking old to hit those bombs.
If Flunk hits those fucking bombs,
he's
you
got
can have fucking pieces of old man all over this fucking stadium. Those bombs will blow his fucking jelly bones apart.
Now, Flunk, mind you, is about 7 years older than he was at Stranglemania 1. He now is 134 years old.
That's right. His bone structure is made out of the same material as marshmallow cream.
I have a question for you, Guido.
Yes.
Is it true to the speculation that Terry Flunk is actually the three-eyed scarab wearing a mask? Is that true?
Let me tell you something. That is all speculation, goddammit.
Well,
Chuck Terry Funk is a living legend, goddammit.
They have
the same stature. He might be 114 years old.
Oh, God. That was close.
Very fucking close.
Now, wait a minute. That's saying the same thing as asking if his asshole Andy really has a pussy between his butt cheeks.
That's all up in the air right now. That's very, very possible. But there's no fucking connection between Terry Flunk and the nipple flippule.
Oh, wait.
He's going for the arm sandwich, and he doesn't quite get it. Now, Guido, I want to make a point right now about our unbelievable main event. This match is not a match to the winner. It is not a match to the submitter. It is not a match to even the loser. It is a match to the death.
This is Strangle fucking Mania 2. Of course it's a match to the death. These are all death matches. The only way you win is to fucking kill your opponent.
I want to make a point right now about Armageddon's stupid looking fucking camouflage pants.
He got them at the Army Navy store for $4.99. Although this time he is wearing boots.
He is wearing boots because the barbed wire is extra prickly today.
Armageddon back on his feet, taking advantage of Flunk.
Flunk's putting his ass up in the air, now hoping that Armageddon will, Andy Armageddon asshole, will like use his asshole for his pleasure.
Watch this right here, reversal by Flunk.
Oh,
he shot you.
Oh, right there. Shit.
Holy shit.
We almost saw the end of fucking Fat Boy right there in the flesh. Now, look at this right here. Drunk Terry Flunk lost to the infamous Lord of Death Matches, and by that I'm talking to the one and only Cactus Sack.
That's right, Cactus fucking Sack.
Terry Flunk lost to Cactus Sack on Stranglemania 1 right from Hiroshi, Japan. And now he's back, and he's been on the comeback trail ever since, Luscious, and he's on it. He's got his disco stripes back on and his black panties, and he's ready to do damage all over asshole.
I'll tell you what, 3D.
It's very true.
He might have got his ass whipped on the last Stranglemania by Cactus Sack, but nonetheless, he's a fucking deathmatch Stranglemania. Oh, my God!
Oh,
that
shit very
was
well
fucking...
Be
now, wait a minute. I have once again brought a guest to the table. I want to bring a guest to the table, somebody that actually constructs the barbed wire. I have, from the shipyard of Columbus, Missouri, I have brought with me Jed Thumpman, who's in charge of shipping and deck... In shipping and docking, and he's got barbed wire fences all over the warehouse. Jed Thumpman, welcome to Stranglemania.
What up, y'all?
Now, I want you to tell me about the barbed wire. How deep does it penetrate the flesh? How dangerous is this so-called barbed wire?
Well, it depends on what kind you get. I mean, you can get as far as a 3-foot gas if you get the right razor wire.
So what is the difference between razor wire and barbed wire, and what are we looking at here on Stranglemania from Napoleon, Japan?
Basically, what I'm seeing here is Terry Flunk taking advantage of his cat-like reflexes from falling towards the ground.
I don't want to know about the wrestling, you fuck. Tell me about the barbed wire. What kind of barbed wire? Is that razor wire or is that barbed wire?
Well, you got a 3-centimeter pointed razor wire intent. Now, that's cubic zirconia running through that there. Now, that's hot.
It's heated barbed wire.
It electrified.
Electrified barbed wire.
Terry Flunk is about to go over the edge.
Ted Thumpit, thank you for coming.
All right, thank y'all very much.
Coffee and hot wings in the green room.
All right, thank
you. Now, back to Stranglemania, Guido. Look at this right here. You have got drunk Terry Flunk taking a beating, but you have to admit, a man of that age, a man of any age, he is incredible, and he can take damage.
That's just like I was saying before, 3D, before you really interrupted me with your stupid fucking friend and didn't tell her shit. Now, drunk Terry Flunk. Yeah,
there's his manager, Classy Eddie Abbas.
That's right.
Terry Flunk's manager, Classy Albert Abbas, has got a flaming chair to slap against asshole Andy Armageddon.
Now, Terry Flunk, yes, it's true. He got his ass whipped before, but he's a living legend, goddammit.
He's
a deathmatch veteran.
Get
battle
the fucking ref.
He threw it at Ernie Abbas.
He threw it at the referee. He did not throw it at his manager.
Let me tell you something. Courteous and Albert Awesome is definitely a top-notch fucking manager, and there's no way drunk Terry Flunk's going to hurt his own man.
When drunk Terry Flunk lost to Cactus Sack in 1994, the first thing he did on his comeback trail was he acquired the skills of amazing Ernie Abbas. And ever since then, he has been on the comeback trail.
There you see
him again. Amazing Ernie. What's he giving him this time? It looks like the cross branding iron. He's going to light it on fire.
It's the Triple X Ranch branding iron.
There we have the X handed off by Tony Abbas to Terry Flunk. He's ready. He's heating it. It's piping hot.
Now, right there, ever since Terry Funk has acquired the skills of acrobatic Emily Abbas, you will see that he has become.
Oh my God!
And there it is!
One more camera!
Oh my God! Right in the fucking exploding mind, barbed wire!
There's no coming back from that, fellas. There's no coming back from that.
I think Terry Funk is victorious this time around, Guido!
I bet you one thing, Anakin Abbas is more than happy right now.
Oh, yes. That was his doing.
Oh,
that
yes.
That was amazing Anakin Abbas is doing in lighting the branding iron and handing it to Funk. Funk distracted asshole Andy Armageddon and led him into the barbed wire bed of death.
I'll tell you, that's why fucking asshole Andy Geddon's in the barbed wire right now. Because Courteous Alice Abbas gave Terry Funk the burning axe, which sent his fucking fat bitch ass into that fucking barbed wire.
See, there's Eric Abbas on the side with Terry Funk.
Eric Abbas right there behind Funk. Now there you have Funk, still provoking.
He's putting glass on his back.
Now watch right here, Guido, watch. Right there, you see Andy Armageddon shaking his head saying, no, I'm not playing this wrestling shit no more. This is real.
I'm really
I'm
hurt.
Fucking hurt for real.
He's fucking dead.
That guy on the stage is stabbing him in the ass with a stick.
Now notice Terry Funk leaving him alone because he's hurt for real, ladies and gentlemen.
Fuck no, he ain't gonna leave him alone. He's gonna poke him with a fire stick.
He's
right
still
up
provoking
his fucking
him.
Asshole.
I haven't seen Terry Funk this hot since he managed the amazing Peter Lovebush back in the day.
Yes, but he's hot right now.
He's very hot right now.
There he is.
Look,
he's gonna catch him on fire.
Look.
At that.
Armageddon signaled to him,
again,
I'm really hurt.
Armageddon,
he's putting out the fire.
Once again, Armageddon, not playing right now, not
he's
wrestling,
really
not entertaining, he's hurt.
Terry Funk's trying
what
to hit him.
What the hell is Alexi Abbas doing on the side provoking this all the while?
Alexis Abbas is the one that's responsible for the death of asshole
he's branding
Andy
him.
Armageddon.
He said he's done wrestling and he's clearly branding his ass.
Let me tell you something right now, goddammit. Let me tell you something right now.
Calm down, Luscious Johnny.
I'm through with this.
Johnny.
It's ridiculous.
Johnny. Oh, he's beating up innocent victims.
That's Velvet Curtain Leg. That is Velvet Curtain Leg.
Velvet Curtain Leg. Just an usher boy that works for the Syphilis Arena.
And you'll see in the background right there, Courteous Lenny Ablis is behind him with the board, and he's encouraging Funk to keep on with his brutality. God
there in the back, gorgeous Gary Grant getting ready, holding Terry Funk back.
Who the fuck are you talking about?
I'm talking about the cameraman, gorgeous Gary Grant.
That's cameraman number 4. Get the fuck away from him, Funk.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner of the main event of Stranglemania 2.
Right.
And that winner is 145-year-old legend, deathmatch legend, drunk Terry Funk.
And we look at this. This motherfucker in the barbed wire is dead. And drunk Terry Funk could give two fucks about it. And who else better to deserve it than drunk Terry Funk?
What happened to the integrity and professionalism in the wrestling sport today?
You're looking at something new, Luscious Johnny. You're not looking at a
deathmatch.
This is the deathmatch, Luscious Johnny. I don't know what you thought you were going to see, but you are witnessing Stranglemania!
I wanted to see some sportsmanship like professional wrestling.
Hey, fuck you!
Johnny, suck my dick, you faggot!
My dick, get.
You motherfucker! I'll fuck you up!
Get the fuck out of here!
You son of a bitch!
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sorry.
This is Strangle fucking Mania 2, goddammit!
Ladies and gentlemen,
pussy shit.
Wait a minute! Words from Funk! Guido, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hit your friend.
Fuck him! Let's hear what Terry Funk has to say. Talk louder, asshole.
Yes, he's dead. He doesn't even have the name right.
FMW is dead.
He's talking about FMW fucking mad wrestling.
You're a piece of shit.
Ooh.
They call him a piece of fucking shit.
Now right there's your winner, ladies and gentlemen, of Stranglemania 2.
And there
drunk Terry Funk, and laying down in the bed of bloody barbed wire is none other than asshole Andy Armageddon, the legend himself, but now not proven to be a legend, more or less proven to be a myth, because he's not tough, he's only a pansy bitch
and
with
of course,
a pussy
Funk,
under his nuts.
Funk in the ring with his manager,
get
Larry Abbas.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Diamond Donovan Douglas, better known as
Indeed.
And I'm handsome Harley Quistella, better known as Guido. And my friend, who's going to pick
his... I'm Luscious Johnny Stark.
And this has been Strangle fucking Maniac 2.
Woo!
Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to Stranglemania's additional DVD footage. I'm 3D, better known as Diamond Donovan Douglas.
And I'm Handsome Harley Quistella, better known as Guido.
Hey, Guido, it would seem that you have recently jumped in the ring and became a wrestler yourself, judging by all the platinum and gold hanging off your feeble body.
Well, let me tell you something, brother. When you stepped back and took your leave of absence of the wrestling squared circle because of your heart palpitations, I took your spot and I jumped in the ring. I jumped into the bloodiest death matches. I've jumped into the age-induced barbed wire thumbtacks on fire, exploding landmine sand beach matches, and I've captured every title possibly known to man on all 10 continents and 15 states and all countries worldwide. And I see by your outfit, you've become quite the air pilot yourself.
Well, not exactly a pilot, Guido, but actually a bus driver. And you're all welcome to jump on our bus as we go on yet another exploration of wrestling. This time, we're going all the way to Agora, Japan. Starting things off, we are going to witness live in person, brutal, hardcore, six chick tag team action. We're going to see once again in the ring, slapping her spandex thong back on, Sweet Sugar Ass. This time, her partners will be Molly Ringworm and Cherry Bomb as they go up against.
That's right. You heard it right here. Sweet Sugar Ass, Molly Ringworm, the Cherry Bomb, the 80s chicks all day versus the three of the meanest, toughest dykes in the wrestling profession today. And when I say mean dykes, these bitches are hardcore. We're talking about the return of Sweaty Ned and Armageddon, as well as the dyke known as Stan the Man.
Stan the Man.
As hardcore as they come, this bitch is rough and tough as nails. Also, the All-American Whore will be their third tag team partner, squaring off against the other three hot pussy
bitches. That is going to be completely stunning in six bitch tag team action. But that's not all. Let us not forget the big tag team match that will be also taking place right in front of your peepholes. I'm talking about the Mustache Riders for the first time for your viewing pleasure. Of course, I'm talking about Blake the Tank Jobber and his partner, Big Mike Blossom.
That's right, the Mustache Riders in the ring in full action. And they'll be going up against brand newcomer to Stranglemania, Pudding Patty, along with his partner, the Heartbreak Boy, Morton Michaels.
Morton Michael gets some screaming and whiling.
Oh, he's the high flyer of sorts, if you could call him that myself.
He sure brings the ladies up to the ring, and he brings the women attendance skyrocketing through the roof. And also our main event on the special three matches that we're bringing to you added flavor. I'm talking about the exploding barbed wire death match, Guido. And you know I'm talking about the one and only former world champion of Stranglemania, Sweet Baby Bitch, is back in action. Guido, tell him who the fuck his opponent is.
Well, before I say that, I'd like to ask you a question, 3D.
Shoot.
Who else besides Sweet Baby Bitch can grab that barbed wire and make it explode all over his asshole and his ball sack and without a drop of blood leaking out of his anus crease? None other than Sweet Baby Bitch. And he'll be going up against another newcomer, the legend in Japan, the legend worldwide, all the way down to Pluto, Lightning Legs Mitch.
Double L, Lightning Legs Mitch gets it on with Sweet Baby Bitch. It's going on straight from Japan. This is Stranglemania, the DVD, the extra footage. Guido, congratulations on all of your recent victories and many more to come. And everybody, hand me your ticket and let's enjoy the ride.
Let's go down to the ring and wrestle.
All right, wrestling fans, this is it. The extra footage, DVD style, Stranglemania. We're gonna see Sweet Sugar Ass, Cherry Bomb, and Molly Ringworm squaring off against three other fucking bitches.
That's right, these three bitches happen to be some ruthless dykes. And they are Sweaty Ned and Armageddon, the All-American Whore, and Stan the Man.
Guido!
Yes, 3D.
Let the people know something about Stan the Man. I've heard this and that about Stan the Man. However, I've never seen the fucking whore in action myself. How long has Stan the Man been teaming with
these other two fucking pansy pussy whores? How long has these three bitches been together? Well, I'll tell you something, 3D. Stan the Man has been in the wrestling profession for more than 800 years. Not actually physically, but mentally. She's been preparing for the equivalent of 800 years. But fuck that! Holy shit, sweaty net grabs fucking sweet sugar puss on her way down to the ring and his women handling her. I'll tell you one thing about sweet sugar ass. That's a hot bitch right there. I'll tell you one other thing. Those chairs are enjoying her spine, ravishing into the metal plating of the frames of them. Now, the hairstyle worn quite consecutively by Sweaty Ned and Armageddon, the bright red fruity hairstyle worn by Sweaty Ned, does that help her when she's hiding in the camouflage bushes of her hometown of Turkey? Well, let me tell you something, 3D. Of course it helps her, because she only hides in berry bushes. Now, when you're in a berry bush with red hair, the camouflage as the bush and the red as the berry, much like her berry. Now, everybody does know that Sweaty Ned and Armageddon right now choking the shit out of that bitch. Sweaty Ned and Armageddon is in fact the woman of asshole Andy Armageddon, who was a predominant figure of Stranglemania 2, Guido.
It's true, 3D, but right now asshole Andy Armageddon's bitch, Sweaty Nedden, is outside manhandling women left and right, leaving Cherry Bomb in the ring by herself with
Stan the Man.
Stan the Man, who has been wrestling for, as we mentioned, mentally 800 years. But now Sweaty Ned is back in the ring, once again with her dick tactics.
Now, everybody knows across the Orient, there's always been much speculation that Stan the Man, not in the ring at the moment, but of course, the speculation has been running rampant.
What the fuck is that?
Stan the Man actually has a penis in his blue or her blue jeans. True or fact, Guido, you've been in the ring with Stan the Man before in the past. Is there a penis hiding between her pussy lips? Yes or no?
I have been in a schoolboy pin by her once before. I don't know if it was a penis. I don't know if it was her protective cup that she wears over the mons pubis of the pussy bone. I'm not sure. But one thing I do know right now, that Cherry Bomb came straight from a slumber party straight to the ring. She was staying the night last night at Sweet Sugar Asses and came to the ring in her sleeping apparel.
Why does Cherry Bomb choose to wrestle in her PJs? Is that part of her strategy to make her opponents assume she is sleeping when in fact she's wide awake and has Sweaty Ned and Armageddon in her flying monkey flip?
Well, that's part of it, but the other part of it is she's flat broke. She squats. She stays at other bitches' houses. She calls them slumber parties, but really she's a fucking squatter, and that's all she had semi-clean for the day to wear to the ring, which she slept in last night, 3D.
Of course she's a squatter. All bitches are squatters when it's time to squat. Now, Sweaty Nothing with a smooth pin, but to no avail.
That's right, there wasn't avail, but this happens to be an elimination match. Once one bitch is pinned, another bitch jumps in the ring and fills her slot. Right now, Molly Ringworm is in there, getting her face cheeks slapped the fuck off by Sweaty Nothing, who tags into the All-American Whore.
Molly Ringworm, a very, very successful pop star, singer, / dancer in Japan, as well as in Hong Kong.
That's right. She got her roots started out from her hometown of Lager, Russia, where she was in the Rat Pack with four other bitches and dudes making movies, making money, but she hit the rocks as soon as she started injecting the steroids into her pussy.
Injecting the steroids and injecting the ice heroin.
That's right. But right now, the only ice heroin flowing is her on the floor as Sweaty Ned and comes back in for the test of strength, which doesn't work to her avail because Stan the Man is, in fact, a man and is stronger than a woman.
Stan the Man's jeans are, in fact, tight gripping around her manly hips, manly knees, and man-like thighs.
And if you look close enough, 3D, I'm not sure. My glasses aren't to the right specs as they used to be, but I think I might see a ball through the jeans.
You know, these tags are so quick, I don't even see them taking place. Whoa! 1 minute, Stan the Man's in the ring, you blink, and there they are,
tagging quicker than lightning, and there's the All-American Whore from Croatia.
That's right, the All-American Whore from Croatia, which is indeed a spectacle, if you will ask me, or if you don't, it still is a spectacle, because she is from Turkish Alaska, and yet she's All-American at heart, pure and simple. Wow, Sweaty Ned, with the drop, she went for the pussy plex and clearly missed.
Yes, she did. She missed, of course. Now, you'll notice the All-American Whore has a patch of white hair on the front of her head. That, of course, is from dunking for apples.
Oh, speaking of, she taps out. Sweet Sugar Ice makes her tap out.
She's already out, huh?
It's 2-on-2 now.
Now she has a patch of orange hair in the front of her head from dunking for apples in barrels of toxic waste.
That's Stan the Man.
What's that in the background? That giant Sun Ra blow up air thing?
That is Sweet Sugar Ass's power source. If that was not there, she would have no sugar for her sweet ass. That is what she likes to call her sugar bowl.
Now Armageddon and Stan the Man double teaming Sweet Sugar Ass and her flat bedpan ass.
Now, I'd like to ask you a question, 3D.
Yes.
What gives? Stan the fucking Man seems to have some black makeup coming from under her right eye cheek.
Style, Guido. Something you may lack in the ring, although you do have finesse. I will give you that. You have finesse and you have skill due to all your world titles. But style, Guido, is something you lack and you know nothing about.
When it comes to me winning my matches, 3D, it takes no style. It takes fear, pure brawn and brains.
Well, before my heart condition led to my retirement, I knew everything there was to know about style, which is something I know much about.
You and your fucking heart condition, always with your heart condition. Get down there with those bitches right now, and you can wrestle them with or without weak chair shots or heart conditions.
Did you notice how soft and feather-like and passionate that chair shot was?
It's more like she caressed her head with it than hitting her with it.
Oh, right there. Nice.
And face in the muff. Holy shit, that was the tulip takedown.
I don't know if her pop music career will be quite as successful. Molly Ringworm in deep trouble on the outside of the ring. And on the inside of the ring, Sweet Sugar Ass with a power flip on the man, Stan.
Now let me tell you something about Sweet Sugar Ass right here. Sweet Sugar Ass is used to being the underdog. She's small. She's feminine. She's used to wrestling these big, manly truck stop driver dykes. Now, if you'll notice, the whole match, she'll always get her ass whipped. She'll always get a little soft, feminine angel. Like pussy ass in trouble. Oh, besides the flying crane hook right there, she always is the underdog, but she always comes back to take control and to win. Also, 1, 2, oh no. And if you'll notice, Molly Ringworm is nowhere to be found. Perhaps she is eliminated as well.
A victory will do nothing for the fact that Sweet Sugar Ass's ass, in fact, is flatter than a crushed loaf of bread.
It might be flat, but it fits on my flat and out broken nose perfectly.
Her ass is flatter than a fucking cutting board. Her ass is flatter than an ironing board. Her ass is flatter than a deflated fucking...
Her ass looks like an inverted ski slope.
Her ass is flatter than an inflated inner tube.
With no air whatsoever.
However, her highlights are quite beautifully done at Fantastic Sam's.
It's true. She goes to Fantastic Sam's and Bubbles puts the tinfoil highlight wraps into her hair with, oh, here comes the chair into the ring now. This is not fair play. She could break her neck.
Oh,
good thing
plastic.
She put her arms up.
The plastic right across the flat ass.
Now, if you'll notice, 3D, Sweaty Ned wearing a very different ring apparel than what we're used to seeing her in. She is in the camouflage fatigues instead of her normal spandex-clad camel-toe revealing apparel.
Thank God.
Here comes a double team move. No, the
Stan
single
the
move.
Man.
But that actually was a double team move because even though the appearance of a woman, it is a man. So therefore, it is two wrestlers and one pair of jeans. Strictly Wranglers.
Right here, the spinning whirl-to-whirl around. Oh, she had to be at least 4 inches off the mat.
4 feet off the mat and going 80 miles an hour straight. She goes for the 3 count to no avail whatsoever. And right back into the corner to Sweaty Nitten where the tag takes place and she's going for the sorbet sausage dip.
Well, allow me to say this right now. Sweaty Nitten Armageddon with sweet baby bitch ass up over her shoulders.
Wow, you can see her pussy through the side of her shorts.
In the air, and now across her knees and to the mat. Now, notice the fucking...
1, 2, Ow, the bridge!
Oh, the strength of the neck!
That's right, that comes from the powerful back, arching the back, when, in fact, sweet sugar-ass's boyfriend, sweet bitch-ass, who we will be seeing coming up, sticks his very soft and small penis into her pleasure puss.
Armageddon using her belt as a weapon here, and now it's
not
in
no
the hands
fucker
of sweet sugar ass. Sweet sugar ass whipping. Oh,
she spanks her on the ass piece. Holy shit. Fucking sweetheart, sweaty Nettin's ass looks much like a half deflated bread loaf when you jump out front of the oven when it's cooking.
A half deflated cake.
There you go, bud. With the power press bomb, 2, 3. Did she get her? She got her!
Thank God that shitty ass match is over with.
Holy fuck, sweet sugar ass gets took down. Well,
her
was
ass
very
looked
impressive.
Like a half bag of charcoal, Guido.
Her ass might have looked like something that I wish not to speak about, but however, getting into our next match is a whole different story, because these aren't bitches, these aren't dykes, these are wrestlers.
Let's get down to the action.
And holy shit, 3D, there he is, the man himself, the heartbreak boy, Martin Michaels, in all of his hair, three-tiered mullet splendor, and his partner, right behind him, following the duck himself, Puddin' Patty.
And let's not forget about their opponents, Guido. Holy shit, the Mustache Riders. I'm talking about Blake the Tank Jobber and awesome Big Mike Blossom.
That's right, and Blake the Tank not looking so good right now on that pile of chairs on his fluffy ass.
They better watch out for all four pairs of those piss yellow boots coming from the Mustache Riders, and they are devastatingly dangerous.
That's right, but they might be devastatingly dangerous, but I don't know if they can handle the power of that fucking haircut right there, 3D. Holy fuck.
Holy fuck is right.
And look at the side of his tights, it says hard cock.
Hard cock. Hard cock and long mullets.
That's right. What better combination could any wrestler ask for?
Sausage slam right there from the man himself, Blake the Tank.
That's right. Blake the Tank from Stone Mountain, Oahu.
Stone Mountain, Oahu's own Blake the Tank. And he's got what we call in the business a coconut forehead.
And he's also got what we'd call a crack habit.
Yes, he does. And here comes Big Blossom. Big Mike Blossom off the top rope.
Oh, 8 feet off the top rope.
Holy shit. Sweet ass hamper clothesline.
Now, I'd like to point something out right quick right here. What fucking devastating action we have here. Oh, how the fuck did he juice? I see no razor blade. I see no form of him even contemplating to use any foreign object to pierce his forehead with, yet he's bleeding.
You're not gonna see that shit. That's the Heartbreak Boy.
That's right, and this is 100% real.
The Heartbreak Boy is from Austin, Arkansas. What a fucking fan favorite the Heartbreak Boy is, with the fringes and the tassels coming off of his white shredded spandex.
Oh, the high-flying Blake the Tank Jobber off the top rope. And I'd like to point something out right now, 3D. I happen to know the inside information on this, as I usually do. Blake the Tank has a soft and vibrant bushy mustache, if you will.
He does. Thick, woolly mammoth, thick, extra thick, woolly, fulfilled mustache.
That's right, but if you'll notice.
Oh, Puddin' Patty is in the ring. This is what the people really came to see.
Holy shit. If you throw him in water, he'll float. Holy
dark
fuck.
Chocolate pudding.
That's here right. He is. Oh, what the hell? He just lands his asshole right onto the fluffless mustache on the face of Blobberts. And like I was saying, Big Mike Blossom, if you'll notice, doesn't have a mustache.
No, he doesn't. That's
but yeah,
the only
he's
problem.
One half of the mustache wires. And I'll tell you why, goddammit. It's because of the simple fact me and Tony Sherbert were in a match against the Mustache Riders, and a loser loses his mustache match.
I saw the match. You and Fruity Tony Sherbert.
That's right. And in fact, what had happened was me and Big Mike Blossom pinned each other at the same time, both losing our mustaches in that match.
Exactly.
I actually had a very nice 3-foot-long handlebar rider mustache myself.
Your mustache had nice curls on both tips.
Rally fingers, if you will.
Yes, or if you won't, they still curled on the cheeks, and it was lovely. However, Fruity Mike Sherbert's mustache...
Oh, he goes to throw him out of the ring, and he misses the opening of the rope because he's fucking fat.
Tell me about Blake the Tank's forehead. Well, Blake the Tank's forehead is built much like a tank. That's why he is called Blake the Tank. And you'll notice the juice marks in it as well. And that's from a secret snake that he keeps in his trunks.
Only a secret to us, but not a secret to Big Mike Blossom.
Which has nothing to do with his look or gimmick, Blake.
Or attacks. His yellow boots. And their patent putty, putty patent potty is getting the fucking back slap.
Oh! Now, Putty Patty might look short, he might look fat, he might look weak, but in fact, his center of gravity, holy fuck, his center of gravity is much lower to the floor than these monstrosities called the Mustache Riders, which means he can absorb the punishment. He can absorb the pain, and he can absorb the power of the yellow boots besides that reverse DDT move.
Damn it, Guido, black panties, yellow boots, mustaches, and mullets. That is the Mustache Riders.
This is a clear-cut case of classic wrestling, 3D, classic wrestling, which I would know everything about inside and out, including the deathmatch.
Sweet backhand tag right there. Tags into Mike Blossom.
Now, I've actually seen the Mustache Riders in a match before where their moulets have been tangled.
Yes, they'd sometimes tie their moulets together in what's called a reverse clothesline.
No sell!
No sell! No way! Puddin' Patty Potty is way too big to sell a move that big.
He actually tried to jump for him, but he's the master of the one-inch vertical jump. Let's see if he'll
jump
for him on this.
Watch this.
Oh! Holy fuck, he almost went back. One, two, no! Oh, more
the heartbreak boy was right there.
The hard-cut kid makes the save, who was bleeding for no apparent reason, and right now he probably thinks his face is gushing full of blood, but yet it's one dried-up little crust on his eye.
Guido, he's bleeding in what we call the hard way.
That's right, he's coming straight out of his heart because that kid's got so much heart that I can't fucking stand it.
He is the heartbreak boy.
That's right, a heartbreak and a heart throb and a heart cock.
A hard cock?
And a double clothesline sends Big Mike Blossom onto his ass.
Onto his ass! And thankfully not onto his mustache.
Now, 3D, if you actually own a special pair of glasses that you put on, you can see through those black parts in the rips of Hardcock's pants.
I'm glad I don't have those I'm glad I don't have a mustache either. However, I'm glad I don't have those sunglasses.
Well, the sunglasses are shaped like a mustache.
But I do wish I had a pair of those spandex with the fringes and the tassels.
I have a pair of them that are missing the black parts, or the rips are on the rear side of the anus area and one of the balls.
I am growing a triple tier three-story mullet, though, and I'm in hopes of returning to my wrestling career in the Orient.
He missed! Holy shit, if you'll notice, look at the beautiful, fluffy waves of fucking hair that we, that's what we call it in Japan, is hair. And look at the fluffy waves of amber on the head of Morton Michaels. Not only is it one wave of long, fluffy, vibrant hair, holy fuck, Big Patty at the top of
Big Patty!
He clearly drop kicked him on the top of the head, and he missed the top of his head, landing straight on his dick.
That was a soaring flop kick. And here comes Morton Michaels!
High flying adventures.
Two, three.
Holy shit. Morton Michaels picks up the win against the Blossom One himself, Mike Blossomage.
Morton Michaels and Puddin' Patty have taken it home. Oh. Oh, right to the face.
Now,
two.
Right here is a classic case of adding insult to injury, 3D.
Yes.
This is not necessary. Get these big fucks out of the ring. Clearly, Puddin' Patty and the Hardcock Kid were victorious, and they're in the ring right now just getting fucking pummeled by their opponents.
The Mustache Riders aren't going home that easily.
Holy shit.
They're not going out like that. Not before giving Puddin' Patty a couple soft, very friendly, very sensitive chair shot.
Well, I don't know about you. All this sensitivity and all this beautiful hair is getting me riled up. It's getting me ready for our exclusive bonus extra footage deathmatch coming up right now, 3D.
Holy shit. This is our main event right here. None other than himself, sweet baby bitch, and Lightning Legs. We call him Double L around here.
That's right, Lightning Legs Murray, a newcomer to the death match right here on Stranglemania. But he might be a newcomer, but he has experience. As you can see, he's already rearing sweet baby ass back into those barbed wire spider web exploding ropes.
Sweet baby ass. Now, we've seen his woman wrestle earlier today. She took
oh! fuck! And notice the fucking referee and Double L both fall to the mat. And good thing the referee has those explosive-proof goggles covering his forehead and not his eyes.
Smoke protruding from the sweet locks.
Holy shit. I don't even know how to commentate. I know we've been color commentary commentators for over 25 years now, 3D. We've been working together, and I don't even know how to call a match like this because that's just pure brutality.
It completely blew the eardrums right off of Double L.
If you'll notice Double L's haircut, he has the shark spikes cut into the buzz cut of his 50 Styles Marines cut of his karate gi.
Let me tell you something about Lightning Legs. His kickspan is that of the pressure of each one of those kicks is 4,500 pounds as the concentration he draws from the center of the earth.
Well, let me tell you something, you motherfucker. One thing you might not know is that Lightning Legs Murray, he's not a wrestler. He's not a wrestler. He's not a hardcore deathmatch specialist either. He's a martial arts karate specialist.
He is not a karate, Guido.
He's wearing a gi.
It is a gi. However, it is a gun poi.
A gun poi gi. Right, which is the highest level of karate there is.
That is clearly a gun poi.
It might be a gun poi, but the question here is, will the lightning force Cobra Strike's other legs prevail over the wrestling stylish of sweet bitch ass?
Sweet bitch ass has been in these type of matches.
Like Coon strikes for a straight takedown, and he rolls him over to sit on his ass because he's getting tired of standing up.
This right here is simply called the reverse sausage bend.
I think he's just sick of standing up, and his butt cheeks make for a nice cushion to sit down.
Now right here, you see Murray in a lot of trouble. Murray's in,
One thing about this match that all the juggalos out there listening and watching might want to know, 3D, that this is actually not a pinfall match. You must actually knock your opponent out for 10 seconds or outside of the ring for 20. As stout as that might sound, that is the fucking rules, goddammit.
Absolutely.
If you want to say something about it, come try taking one of my belts, you fucker.
Now, these kicks you're seeing right here are, in fact, as soft as they look.
No.
However, the barbed wire is as sharp as it looks.
Now, you're a fucking asshole, because right now you're always telling me about harnessing your chi and bringing your power from your soul. Now, they might look soft, but the fact is, he's channeling his injury energy from his itch, through his balls, through the end of his dick.
Come on now, like
bringing
those
the
kicks
lightning out.
Those kicks wouldn't fucking hurt my grandmother.
Then why the fuck is sweet bitch ass down the floor, bleeding, agonizing in pain, you stupid fuck?
He's those selling!
Kicks, though each one of those kicks are as ruthless as a mule's fucking kick.
Maybe for you, Guido, but if I was still wrestling, I'd have fucking Murray, legs deep, asshole penetrated on top of one of those fucking turnbuckles.
No, you wouldn't, because you don't.
Neck shredded in the barbed wire.
You don't have the Gung Pao Gai Gi. And that's all it takes, really. And he's on the edge right now. He might be going into that exploding barbed
wire. You see that barbed wire bush? His gi with him in it would be entangled, encrescinated, imperviated into the fucking
that
bush.
That gi is made out of metal, 3D. It bends the barbs of the barbed wire. It's impenetrable. And if you notice something right now, I want to give very, very, very special credit to the doctor that put the tape on the shoulder of sweet bitch ass, because that tape is going nowhere.
Very, very important match for both of these men, as their entire families are in the crowd, and this is a number one contenders match for,
look at the arm,
the winner of this match, Guido, as you know, Harry, if I can call you that in public, as you know, this match, the winner of this match will be featured on Stranglemania Tray, if you will.
Yeah, but I take insult over the whole Harry thing. You know I dropped that name when I lost that mustache match, goddammit.
All right.
The mustache is gone. I'm not Harry no more. I simply am Guido.
You know, you stepped into the ring and you became a different person. You became a different person.
You know, you had your palpitations and your heart problems. I fell for you. Who was there at the hospital side? Who was there changing the bedpan? I was. Nobody else, you fucking asshole. Now that I'm on top, now that I'm winning the belts, you want to come and you want to stab me in the back? Well, when you get through your physical therapy for your heart, I challenge you, motherfucker.
Call the action in the ring.
God damn it.
All I'm seeing right now is protection on the forehead of the ref. He's going to fucking blow his eyeballs off from the exploding barbed wire, and he don't care. He's not taking the goggles off of the forehead and putting them on the eyes where they're supposed to be protective at.
Is sweet bitch ass a Prell man, a VO5 man, or in fact, is he a suave man?
He actually, now once again, 3D always has, or Guido always has, the inside scoop. He is actually the godson of Paul Mitchell. The only that's not stopping him from exploding right now in that devastating, vicious, razor-sharp razor wire laced with explosives.
Well, thank God he is the godson of Paul Mitchell, because if he wasn't, if his hair wasn't as silky smoothly as it is, it might be tangled within the barbed wire.
That's right. The hot oil treatments have gave it the sheen and the silk enough to slip in between the barbs and not get tangled, much like we've seen many wrestlers over the year in these death matches. They lose by the hair getting tangled,
but not
by their skin.
But it's not doing anything for his dry skin, which is now embedded into the fucking barbed wire.
Perhaps he should have thought of using Lubriderm, too, before the match. Not only the hot oil treatment, but Lubriderm.
And you see, they've begun the countdown, Guido.
The blood is tremendous. There's so much blood coming not only out of the back, the arm, and the face.
The entire building is about to explode.
Holy shit. And all the countdown was clearly for him to get into the ring.
Oh, yes, you're right.
But like I was saying, the blood is dripping from the back. The blood is coming from the arm. The only place that's missing the blood, which will simplify the loss of sweet bitch ass, is the blood out of the anal opening.
Lightning Legs has been a shoot fighter appearing in mixed martial arts matches for the last 16 and a half years. This is his first pro wrestling encounter, but you see, it would appear as if he's right at home.
Now you want to sit here and tell me those fucking kicks are Ginger 3D? I can hear him slapping off the fucking, the sheen wig of the fucking asshole in the ring right now.
Listen to the count. This is an exploding arena match.
He's counting for him to get up. I don't know if you've ever seen Rocky or not before. That's the rules. 10 and on the floor and you're fucking out of there. And the tape on the shoulder still withholding through all the barbed wire. Perhaps he put the Lubriderm onto the tape, not his skin.
Lightning Legs clearly in control of our main event here on the DVD extra footage. Bitch ass in much trouble. The referee continues to count. This is a standing 10 count match.
And he's already up to 6. He's gonna get up.
Oh, Lightning Legs with more kicks, and yet more fucking kicks.
You know, as this match goes on and on and on, 3D, I'm starting to have lose more and more respect for Lightning Legs Murray. Not for the simple fact that he's an experienced 12-level karate martial artist, but for the simple fact he has not one itch, stitch, or witch of wrestling skills in his bone in his body.
Not so much as a fucking armbar.
Now, when it comes to kicks, yeah, he holds it down. When it comes to body slamming, he has no fucking idea from his asshole to the hole in asshole Armageddon's face.
Not even, his kicks aren't even sweet looking.
I smell barbed wire. And why the fuck the sweet bitch ass sliding after him? He wasn't going to attack him. He just wanted to be impressive and look like he was hardcore by taking that bump, because he clearly threw the gi into the barbed wire. Holy shit.
Double
I don't
L,
think they're getting up.
Double L clearly saved by his gung pa gi,
which is made out of metal,
which protected his flesh from the razor ripping barbed wire. Now, the count has begun, Guido, for both men. They must find a way back onto the apron if they're going to win. If they're going to win this match, they must find a way.
If you'll notice, this referee is counting pretty fucking slow. I could have got up to fucking 5 minutes by now.
They're already on
10, halfway there, and they're only halfway up. It's not looking good for either one of these men. Sweet bitch ass wearing his panties, or fucking the Gung Pao Karate Master, Double LM.
They're getting Murray up. Sliding in.
Murray might be the victor in this match. I don't know. It's coming down to it. They're taking it home for sure. What the fuck was that? Some asshole came out and blew fire into the air.
And clearly missed by a good 9 feet.
I think he was supposed to be hitting sweet bitch ass. But in no shape or form did he even notice him out there.
No sell. No, not even close.
How are you going to sell something you don't know it's there, 3D? He clearly didn't even see him there.
More lame-ass kicks.
The flame was so far from him, he didn't even feel the heat. But look, he's having a bitch-ass revival. His bitch-ass blood is boiling, but to no avail. He gets knocked down with the ass kick to the back of his asshole.
Hey, Guido, how about that? Murray's throwing kicks.
Well, that's totally out of his league. That's out of his style. I've never seen him throw a kick. Perhaps he should go back to wrestling when he knows best.
Hey, Murray, throw some kicks.
I bet you his next move will not be a kick.
Give him a kick, dick.
Another kick, and he goes for a third kick. Perhaps a fourth. Oh, the devastating axe kick. That's what ended the blood-boiling bitch-ass barbecue sauce breakdown in the first place.
Why don't they quit fucking counting already? It's getting played out. Now, if you'll notice, somebody in attendance in the crowd clearly shot sweet bitch-ass in the back.
That's true.
He has a bullet hole
in the
back.
Holy shit, the gi has come off. Now he is able to be hurt. His impenetrable skin is no longer impenetrable because the Kung Pao Gi is now off on that Lubadarm skin. And look at the blood is boiling again. He's taking the real kicks to the face. Oh! Now that right there was explosion on bare skin. No Gi involved, 3D. No protection involved. No metal Kung Pao involved.
No blood involved either.
He forgot his razor blade in the dressing room.
It didn't even fucking hurt. I hate Murray. He should stick to auto goods because he has no business in the fucking ring in Osaka.
Now, the reason why sweet bitch ass is bleeding is because he used, Double L used the points of his hair. You see how his hair is shaved to points? He used that to juice Onita, and bitch ass is going for the powerbomb.
Going for, oh, there it was.
No pinfalls.
This is clearly the stale ass standard 10 count match.
And the whip kick match. And you see, he went for the pin to no avail. But I think he gave the pin up not because of the fact nobody was pounding their hand on the mat, but his nose was merely 1 inch from his bare asshole.
If we're lucky, Murray will get to his feet and kick.
I think if we're lucky, he'll stay down and this fucking match will be over.
Oh, running stale-ass clothesline. No sell.
Murray did not sell it because he's used to kicks. He don't know how to sell wrestling moves. However, he is getting a second powerbomb.
Oh!
And if you'll notice how stiff that mat is, 3D, there's no give.
It does not budge an inch. I will say that much. However, it shouldn't budge when he's only 4 inches off the mat.
I like the sweet, big puffy cheeks of sweet bitch ass. They look like big fat cuddly pillows, which I'd like to cuddle with. If I had a mustache still, I'd like to rub it on them.
Hey, all right.
I mean,
he is a cuddly baby face.
Oh, shit.
Bitch.
Oh, my God. His chin was buried up so far to his asshole that his balls weren't covering his eyes like glasses.
Well, that was only the 9th power bomb that,
Well, it might have been the 9th power bomb. At least it wasn't the 5,000th kick. He's
okay.
Up to six. I don't think Murray's getting up.
I hope not, because if he gets up, we can expect a couple kicks.
8. We're going on 9. Sweet bitch ass up to his legs. And he is
it's
out, 3D.
Over.
Holy shit, the referee is more excited than we are because he had to be in the ring the whole time counting.
And now they're letting the crowd know they can return to their seats from their piss breaks and going to get beers because the next match will be starting.
Well,
however,
actually, that
we
was the main event. It's time
we
to
won't
go
be
home.
There until we return with Stranglemania 3.
Sweet bitch ass once again victorious over lame ass lightning legs Murray. And he's in the pitbull pose. Well, for the bonus footage of Stranglemania, I'm Handsome Harley Gustella, better known as Guido.
You are always
not
Guido.
Harry.
And I am Diamond Donovan Douglas, and we will be back soon with Stranglemania 3 one day in the near future, and we will be back with that man.
And running our asshole.
Baby bitch ass. Thank you for joining us on the DVD extra footage, and we'll see you in the ring.
Wrestling!
I read it in the papers. I saw it on TV. guess will be one empty seat when I wrestle at Wembley. I used to tear my shirt, but now you tore my heart.